I'm new to this thing, so I guess we'll see how it goes. Yeah. I wanted to talk to you about brain animatronics, which is basically harnessing EEG technology to understand yourself and control stuff outside of yourself. I'm excited about it because I was originally interested in EEG because I wanted to meditate better, to teach myself to do it because I've always failed hard. And then after that, I got interested in it because of desires to get better at lucid dreaming. And lately, it's been more of an evangelical thing, I suppose, where I think it's awesome. I think a lot of other people think it's awesome, but you don't realize how easy it is to do it yourself. With that said, here's a quick intro to some of the ways that you can get into EEG hacking yourself and some stuff that I've done with it. Excellent. So NeuroSky are the ones that I generally use, and they have a pretty decent price point ranging from about $50 to $200, depending on if you get it used. The problem with the adoption curve is that initially, it's going to be a lot harder to find used ones because lately the price is going up because a lot of people are getting into EEG, which is great, but kind of sucky if you want to buy one. On the other hand, it's pretty affordable. There's most of these systems have one channel and a reference channel, so you don't get a lot of very precise information about different areas of the brain, for example, but it's what you get for the price point. So these three systems, the MindWave is one that's designed for interacting with computers and mobile devices via Bluetooth. So if you're more of a programmer, you probably want to go for that one. The MindFlex is a toy, actually, that is very hardware hackable. And Nekomimi are produced by a different company called NeuroWare out of Japan, but they're those cat ears that you've probably seen that are robotic. And so both of the last two are more sort of hardware-y. If you're very new to hardware, you probably want to go with Nekomimi, and that's how I started out. So they're very open with their stuff, surprisingly. You'll void your warranty by modding it, but they also have sections on their website devoted to the people who are hacking this with Arduino and how to do it yourself. Besides that, Emotive is one of the other big groups that are doing it for the consumer market. Again, they deal mostly with brainwaves, so in the different frequency bands that you'll usually see like that. Like Waleed was talking about, the ones that we generally look at are delta, theta, alpha, and beta. And NeuroSky basically addresses alpha and beta, which are roughly correlated with your attentiveness or focus or alertness, and your relaxation, and those are the alpha waves that he was mentioning. So emotive systems, the Epoch is the older one. It comes with, I think, up to 14 channels, and the Insight is a newer one that's got 5. And they range, I think, about $400 to $500 if you get it new. So it's a bit more expensive, but you get more data. But you also, for the Epoch, have to use saline solution, so it's wet electrodes, which I've heard are kind of a pain to get to keep moistened. And then there's open source systems. OpenBCI is the big one that was just kickstarted, and I'm really excited to get to play with that. I haven't yet, but OpenEEG has been around for a while, and that's if you want to go balls to the wall, build it from totally scratch, which can be a little more expensive, but if you want to really understand your machine, that's the way to go. So, hacking NeuroSky, I've only worked with ones from this company, but I have used all the ones that I mentioned before. This top, there isn't like a laser pointer, is there? Oh, fantastic. This link is one of the foremost, most popular sites for learning the Arduino hack that basically allows you to pull data out of MindFlex and into an Arduino, which you can then hook up to your computer and see the data coming out. You have 11 numbers, basically, coming out of that. Those correlate to signal strength, attention, meditation, and then 8 raw frequency bands. So the NeuroSky is great because you get these normalized attention and meditation values, which roughly are related to beta or alertness and alpha waves or relaxation. And then the last two of these links are things that I've written on the subject, including video tutorials and lots of pictures and stuff. So if you want to get into it, that's where you should go. And of course, I'm always available for questions, which I'll have my contact info at the end. So a little bit, I'm not going to go very far into how to hack this stuff yourself because I don't have many visual aids and I don't have much time. But so Arduino, oh yeah. So Arduino is, as you probably know, well, raise your hand if you do know what Arduino is. Magnificent. So a lot of people actually, it seems, don't know. Arduino is a microcontroller, basically a brain that you can put in electrical devices that you're building. So if you want to have something that takes input, like from a sensor, to see when it's touched, and then controls something based on that, you need a brain to coordinate that. And that's what Arduino does. So I work for this company, Pinocchio. Sorry, a little plug. But I use it actively on my EEG stuff because it's basically an Arduino plus mesh networking. So all of the boards can talk to each other, basically like little telepathic brains that you can have in different robots. So this is useful if you're building network accessories. So you don't want to have to go through a computer, and you don't want to have them all wired together. You can have independent but coordinated hardware. And then mobility, you don't have to be chained to a computer with like your forehead on this cable that's going into your CPU. Things to consider when you're starting to hack a robot. So if you're starting with something that is a consumer product, such as, I love these little six-legged spider bots made by Hexbot, I think. There are a couple of things that will affect how you hack it in the first place. So if you're hacking something that's remote controlled, do you want to hack the control itself or the robot? And that's often dependent on these factors. Weight, do you want to have all your extra junk in your hands or on the robot itself? Can it support it? If you've got a tiny helicopter, it might not be able to carry much more. Complexity, sometimes it's easier to emulate, for example, an infrared pulse for a remote and then control it that way instead of hacking something deep in the guts of the robot or vice versa. Range, if the thing that you're hacking has a remote that gets better distance or works around corners better than what you're using to control it. Power, can you power the remote or the robot off of your controller itself? If so, go with the easier one. And enclosure modding, like will it look super gross and gunky if you have it on the robot itself? And do you care about that? In the case of wearables, often you do. So different ways of modding the hardware. So with the wings that I built, which you'll see in a second, I'm not sure how much time I have left. Are we good? Oh, great, thanks. we should be good. So simple body mod with a Neko Mimi. You've got these robotic ears to start out with. You pull off the ears and they're these little servo nubs. And so you can turn those into pretty much anything you want, even without digging into wiring or anything. Then you get to the point where you're doing cyborg stuff, which is what you're doing on the Neurosky itself. You're doing a simple hack where you open it up, unscrew the screws, and solder on a couple of little cables. And then that's basically all you have to do. So if you want to directly control motors, servos, et cetera, with your controller without modding much of it, then you can do that. Then you might want to lobotomize your little robot. If it's easier for you to control something just by plugging its motors directly into you, or vice versa, you might just take out its brain altogether if it doesn't have many functions. And then, of course, you can mod a remote control, which is a little bit more distant. So stuff that I've done, GIFs aren't working. Oh yeah, they are. So these are the horns that we were talking about. So I was not the final model, thank goodness. But basically, as she walked around the stage, she would concentrate and or relax more, and that would affect what the horns were doing. So usually you get some kind of a cool thing where they like perk up or like go down, but sometimes they get into this weird situation where they're like going back and forth. And so considering the native motion of what you're hacking, it's very important. Likewise, with the wings, okay. So I built these while they were technically, logically broken. So they were stuck in this calibration mode, which looks very nice when you have it built to that specification. However, unfortunately, just on the night of the show, they started working again, which meant that as she walked around the stage, she would get more excited or more relaxed, and they would flop over to the left or to the right. And then it all looked horrible and weird, like she was some kind of broken flapping bird, and I was very distressed. So another thing to keep in mind, technical challenges. And then the helicopter is just fun. This is one where I, you can see this, let's see. So back here, actually, is what the Neko Mimi pretty much look like before you mod them. And then this one wasn't actually based on the Neko Mimi, but it's a mind flex that I've hacked so that you don't have giant pieces of plastic on the side of your head. And instead, it's housed in a pair of basically headphones. And it ended up having better connectivity than the original version, which is not what I was expecting. Yeah, alpha waves more associated with relaxation and chilled outness, and that's what their meditation value is with NeuroSky. And then attention is more beta waves, which are more like, if somebody calls your name, for example, while you're wearing a headset, you'll see a spike up in attention and a spike down in relaxation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.